Hello and welcome. This is We Happy Few. If you need to refer to me as something, feel free to use my Steam ID, VengefulWookie. I paused for a second to let you laugh at it. It's something I picked before and I'm sticking with it. So, what makes this game so unique is the fact that once you die, you're done. Game over. You gotta start from scratch. However, that hasn't stopped me from playing it as much as I have. And I have beaten it a couple times, I just keep trying to shave down the time that it actually takes me to do so. The game is in alpha, so it's very glitchy. But the main point is pretty much escape. The entire... it's kind of like three cities. We'll spend most of our time, if not all the time, in the middle of these. Here's the map. I mean, it fills in as I explore, so right now there's nothing on it. When you start out, there's kind of like three options. You can either tear up the suit that they give you and make a torn suit so you blend in with everyone here. You can keep the suit they give you, so when you go to the second place, you fit in there. Of that second option, if you keep the suit, you can either just run straight to the second city, or you can stay around here and explore a little. I mean, most of the time I end up just doing it a little bit. If you decide to stay here and explore a little bit, if you keep beating these people up, eventually, when you loot them, you should be able to get the same torn suit you'd get if you destroy yours. So I usually try to do that just so I can get the loot that's here first, but I don't like spending too much time here. Most of the time I play this, I get it finished on about day 7. So I guess beating that is my goal. I think I can do it by maybe day 3. No, day 4. Something to keep in mind, if you saw before, I was kind of drinking water out of like this little hand pump on the ground somewhere. That's important because everywhere else besides this first main town, the water is drugged because they want you to be on meds, like kind of like the movie Equilibrium. Yeah, I'm going to be saying a lot. I'm going to apologize in advance for that right now. And probably a couple times in the future each time I realize that I'm doing it. But mainly the point is in the third city there's like a manhole that you kind of have to get inside of. To do that you need a multi-tool. After you get in there, there's a special door. You need a key card to get past that. There is hunger and thirst, those do drain, and if you take those go out, I believe you die. I've never let them really drain out, but I'm assuming you die. And the drug meter, if you get too much of the drug, it's called joy, in your system, you would actually just end up back here in this starting town. Yeah, so this is the silent takedown. I guess it's kind of like Batman Arkham. The graphics do kind of remind me of Bioshock a bit. And the storyline kind of reminds me of, like, Memento or V for Vendetta. Memento because everyone's on drugs that the government wants them to take, or... I'm assuming government. There's, like, these cop guys with these little batons that beat the shit out of you if you're standing out too much. Lots of conformity involved. Actually, one of the stats is called conformity, and it's how well your appearance will blend in with those around you. So I'm not going to stay here too much longer unless I get a suit soon. And I'm probably just going to end up running straight to the main city. Where that, it's pretty much just a large amount of breaking and entering. Until you find all the stuff you need. It's really simple. It gets a little repetitive, but... I would say in the past 24 hours, there's got to be like the hopefully I'm gonna beat it again, but I've played this thing so many times. And there's the torn suit. Right, so now I get to keep my regular simple suit and torn suit. So now they're not gonna, that little eyeball thing isn't gonna go above their head. And they kinda took from Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell at the top corner, if you see the smiling face with the green around it. That means, yeah, right now it's red because I'm on alert because someone just saw me do something I wasn't really supposed to do. What else? But pretty much it has four phases. Gray is just kind of like nothing, just standard neutral. Green means you can pretty much get away with anything. Yellow means you're doing something. If someone sees you, it'll go red, and red is people are going to try to beat the shit out of you. I just picked up a glass bottle. Those you can actually fill up with water from here, so that way you don't have to drink the drugged water if you're in the main cities. I don't need two torn suits. I'll keep this just in case until I get better stuff. The game does have a weapon system and durability. However, that little push you keep seeing me doing, when you have hands, it actually doesn't cost any stamina, and it's quicker. So if it's a one-on-one fight, the weapon isn't really worth it, because it just takes longer. Even though, yes, you do more damage, but still. I happen to prefer the hand-to-hand combat that they have made. I am near positive this game was made using Unreal Engine 4. Actually, before that, you see this newspaper? If you haven't seen it already, I would maybe recommend watching their concept video or teaser trailer, whatever you want to call it. This game is alpha. Still a bit glitchy. I'll point out glitches as I come across them, but in their Kickstarter, the guy sits down, pulls out the newspaper, announcing the Kickstarter date. Happened to be my birthday. Took that as a sign that I had to play this game. And it's kind of up my alley. It's supposed to be 1960s Britain. Which, if you hear the voices, they do... it's British accents. Cheerio and all that jazz. Occasionally, I am going to be going to my map a lot. Mainly because I like knowing where I'm going and what I've already done. So, the reason I'm keeping the other torn suit is just because eventually you can make more suits. That's in the crafting. Oh yeah, left bumper, right bumper don't work for that. These suits. Simple suit is the one I have, the one they start you with. Torn suit I can make from my simple suit. I'm keeping those torn suits because I might want to make more simple suits. That way I can have a thick and a fancy suit. The thick suit is more armor, but you stand out a bit. The fancy suit, you can do whatever you want, pretty much. The dark suit is supposed to have some kind of stealth thing linked to it, but I don't think they fully implemented it because you don't need to be stealthy. Really, if you have thick suit, fancy suit, switching between them, fancy suit when you need to run and get around, thick suit when you're actually fighting, you can just pause it, switch as you need. It's probably the best combination, hence why I'm keeping two torn suits. Good thing about this game, one of the many good things, is that if I drop something on the ground, it stays there. So normally what I end up doing is leaving my torn suits on the floor over here in case I have to go back to that other place, so that way I blend in better. Okay, so this is the main city. This is where we're going to spend about 80% of our time. I mentioned before how I'm pretty sure this game is made in Unreal Engine 4. Or just Unreal Engine, I don't know 4 specifically. I'm assuming just because that's one of the newer ones. But if you see these houses with the red doors, those are the ones we can interact with. So I'm going to climb in. Let's close that behind me. Most of the time, there'll be someone waiting here at the door. If not, no big deal. And this table is why I think the game is Unreal Engine 4. This is like part of that... like when you first open up a new project, they put like these starter elements in there. That table's one of them. It just looks familiar. I just started using Unreal Engine 4 myself, and it's just something that stood out. I actually don't want the raw meat. That gives me negative health when I use it. Oh yeah, and I was talking before how there's water here, but if I drink this, that purple bar is my joy meter. That goes up high enough, I start to just get the drugged effect. The screen changes a little bit, I can get away with doing more stuff. Every house I'm breaking into has one of these. Turning that off gets rid of this alarm system. Also, the inventory is a little annoying, the fact that it'll fill things in as like from starting from the top row to the from left to right. Meaning, what does that mean? It means a lot of things, actually. It means that if I don't organize stuff, it's gonna think I ran out of space when I really have space. I thought I heard the alarm for a second. Huh. Okay, let's beat the crap out of someone. Yeah, if she was downstairs at the main door when I first jumped in, she wouldn't have been up here now. She's probably trying to get past me to turn on the alarm. Sometimes you gotta look away after you kill them. I don't really know if that counts as a glitch or just... I don't know. Okay. Dark linens for that stealth suit I was talking about, I'm not gonna take that, but that sewing kit I need to make any of the more advanced suits. This next room is going to be the bathroom. I don't know why, but the bathrooms usually have good stuff in them. Trash can actually has something special, but some of this other stuff is... Oh, right, what am I doing? Where's my water? Alcohol. And the bottom right corner, I can equip anything that blue that's not a weapon. Difference being, blue stuff, you can be used. White bar underneath means it's a weapon. Oh, except these rocks. These rocks are technically weapons that get slotted in the bottom. They're thrown, though, obviously, as a rock, but... I mean, I'm gonna try to do this as a little bit more of a speed run. As I mentioned before, I want to finish this in a... Sometimes they freeze a little bit when they go to pull out their weapon. Good, he has a wrench. If you have two wrenches and two things of adhesive, the tape, you can combine those into one of the strongest weapons in the game, in my opinion. The weapons have two stats. One is stamina, meaning the amount of stamina it uses up when you use it, and then damage. Clearly, you want low stamina, high damage. Alright, and now that there's nothing else for me to do in this house, good, I have the power cell. What I like to do is open up both doors as a sign to myself that I don't need anything else in there. However, I brought some attention to myself, that's why the thing's blinking red. If I just go around a couple corners, I should lose them as long as I don't do anything too conspicuous. And I believe I mentioned this before, but there's two main things I have to do in this city. One, well, before I leave this city and head to the third one, which at that point the game should be pretty much over. Oh good, I found my second home. It's like an old subway system or something. I like using this because it's something I'll always know where it is. It's marked on the map nicely with that green house thing. And... good. Expansion kits. Expansion kits clearly... all these little padlocks on the screen. Utilities, the bottom right, things that I can hold. Holster would be weapons, and then pocket, I think, is what they call the actual inventory itself. Let me move the mouse cursor. If you haven't seen by the little buttons, I'm using an Xbox controller. When this game comes out, it is going to be released, I believe, dual for PC and Xbox One, but that's going to be in, like, I think mid-2016 is the expected, almost a year from now. Yeah, so these two, the Advanced Electroshocker and Multi-Tool, are the two items that you need to beat the game. I'm actually going to leave some stuff here. Because that's how I normally play. Actually, I'm going to make a couple of these because they are an important item to the game. So let's do this. My two torn suits. I'll put my sewing kits here as well because they're needed. If I'm not taking the suits, I don't need the sewing kit. In that case, I have the tough fabric. Did I get any of the fabrics? No. Okay, yeah, it's tough and fancy fabric or something like that. The fancy one's probably like velour or something. these open safes in homes. It doesn't hurt to have a couple of those with you. Pipe adhesive. Bandages help if you happen to get hit by certain weapons and start bleeding. Chemical station. Nothing yet. Okay. Oh, I can get rid of all my rotten food. I'll do that when I go up. I don't think I got any of the metal things. No, I did not. It was also my problem last time I played. I got everything in a pretty quick manner. I tried to do the same thing now. Actually, I need to eat some food. Do I have anything that isn't spoiled? Yes, I do. Tea, coffee, rotten apple, let's get rid of that. Rotten mushroom, let's get rid of that. I don't even want to eat mushrooms if they're good, little the rotten ones. Yeah, so they'll be on the floor, they'll stay there indefinitely. And there's two buildings that are going to stand out. One of them's a pawn shop, I sometimes refer to as the drug den or crime scene, or shooting gallery, same as drug den pretty much. And the other one's just the butcher shop. The butcher shop I don't need to go to. However, the pawn shop I must go to bid the game. That's the only way I know of to get the broken multi-tool. And then you have to get the other pieces to fix it up. Which are just standard. Drop items. None of those. Pretty much though, when I pass them on my map, I'll get that little an eyeball shape would pop up. However, I'm pretty sure I'll just recognize them from how much I've played these. Usually they're not too far, or at least one of them doesn't end up, but everything's spawned randomly. Like every time you play, it spawns stuff slightly different places. So even though I have played this game a couple times and beaten it a couple times, probably like 1 in 3 times I play it, I end up beating it. It's never the same. I mean, it's always the same, but it's never identical. And here is the important one, the pawn shop. I don't know if you guys can hear that pulsing noise, but that's just in case you happen to walk past it. They try to make it so you can't walk past it. Or at least without not noticing something's going on with this building. I think they did a good job. The light kind of darkens a little bit, gives a nice eerie look. A bunch of corpses everywhere. I think they set it up perfectly for some jump scares, but this is the closest we get to one. Boom. He falls. There's no one to attack. There's really nothing going on in this house. If you know what you're doing, you're just in and out. First time I did it, I was a little... Well, actually, first time I did it, this part glitched. I got stuck in here. I had to lose my progress. Couldn't get through it. Yeah, but the building is, other than the lighting, is exactly the same as the butcher shop, which has some decent items and stuff in there. What was that? Sewing kit. Nice. Sewing kits are important. Tea. Bandages are helpful. Cloth comes in handy. Where's the other fuse? Did I pick it up already? Well, here's one fuse. It's supposed to be next to... There it is. Okay, right, I didn't even do the kitchen yet. That's where most of the stuff is. Let's see, what can I get rid of? Syringe, I have 3 of those, I don't need another. I want that one. Raw meat, I don't want. Victory meat, I don't want. Stew, I'll take, but it's nothing special. The dishwasher usually has decent loot, and there's another sewing kit. And that's all. That's almost all there. I did that another time I played. I just left after I got the 2 fuses. Forgot to actually do with them what I was supposed to. Should be a staircase here. Put these in. The crafting. Basic crafting could be done anywhere. For more advanced crafting, you need a table like this one. health hunger. I might as well just use that now, actually. I need metal bits and a mechanical part. However, this is still a pretty good start, considering that the second day kind of just started. The only other thing that's really difficult to get my hands on is the ID card, which I pretty much have to kill these guys, and they have a lot more health than the regular guys. And eventually, after killing some of them, one of them will have... Usually I end up having two ID cards when I end up getting one. Not sure why, but usually they don't just have one, they usually have two of them. I don't know if there's more than one door in this game that can use that with. But yeah, at this point I'm just going to have to be going in and out of houses to scavenge some parts. If I have another iron thing. I do have another lead pipe. Or is that the same one from the beginning? Eh. I don't know. Maybe I'll make a stop by my house and drop off some parts. I'll raid one more house, see what happens. Yeah, so this guy's at the actual door. Oh, I unlocked the door, I didn't mean to. Yeah, I just activated the alarm by accident. Don't do that. It's not good. Dishwasher. Usually the dishwasher has some good loot in it. Mystery means salt, neither one of those is good. Salt has no positive effect. It's kind of like real life, there's nothing good about salt. Do I actually need? I don't need that much adhesive. And the healing plants I might as well turn into healing balm. Get rid of this. I don't need any rotten food. Coffee, I'll just eat that. Drink that, technically. I just took something I didn't want. I think it was a rotten apple. I don't see it though. Steak, joy, alcohol, pills, jerky. Alright. The only reason I have two of these right now is because one of them I want to, like, in case I run into a safe at one of the houses. No raw meat. No raw meat. Raw meat's bad for you. Unless it's sushi, but they don't... To give you the impression it's like beef or a steak or something that's just not cooked. Frying pan's not even a good weapon. It just hurts when you get hit by it. And yeah, so this gets rid of the alarms. Those apples are so rotten, they look like the ones in Death Note. And they sometimes glitch when they go to equip their weapon. I've gotten killed several times by that. Like, I go to shove them, but it's just like they disappeared. I think this... I'm assuming, however the game's coded, it has them replace the enemy with an instance of the enemy holding the weapon, so there's a brief moment that it doesn't exist. Tough linen. That's the one I wanted. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back and make the things I wanted. The tough suit. So now I'll stand out more. However, I could take a lot more of a beating. I think it's a fair trade-off as long as I don't run in the city. But once again, I'm done with this house, so open both doors and I'm all set. Alright, now back to the house. Oh, good, stay on this path. Yeah, I shouldn't be running. Yeah, but see, like, they kind of walk a little funny. And their faces are white. Reminds me of V for Vendetta. At least the way they did the face paint reminds me of his mask. That might be a British thing. Parliament. Guy Fawkes blew up Parliament. And Parliament's in Britain. I'm not that much of a history buff, so feel free to mock me if you feel like you want to. There's a very slim chance we'll ever meet each other, so... I guess belch is all I have to say. Excuse me if that offended you. If not, embrace it. I just had some pretzels and that was a salty belch. That was actually quite disgusting. There's a chance I might edit that out if I actually do any kind of sound editing. If not, you got my crazy mumbles to myself. Please enjoy. Okay, so I'm going to make one of these a simple suit. And then... Alright, okay, so I'm going to make my simple suit into the thick suit. And then I'm going to make a simple suit out of one of the torn suits that's in there. That should just be a sewing kit, two sewing kits, one sewing kit. One sewing kit, the suit, and some extra cloth, I guess, to cover up the patches that were torn off. Ooh, not the... That's better. Almost dropped that stuff on the floor. Would have been a little upset if I lost that. Alright, so now I'm going to have one of each. Simple, torn, and thick. That simple suit's going to become the fancy suit. If I ever get my hands on fine linen, I already have the two sewing kits. And the other simple suit's already in the inventory here, so thick suit, let's wear that. And hopefully I get some expansion things soon. So I can hold a bit more. Does this need metal bits? It does need metal bits. Alright, so I'll try to refrain from making too many of those until I get... Unless I get a shitload of metal bits somewhere. Metal bits also have the lockpicks, but I'm not even gonna bother with that. I probably should have left more stuff there, but it doesn't, once again, not really that important. And that's most of the gameplay. Just break into houses, make myself at home. There we go, utility expansion. Probably the worst of them, but it's still more inventory space, that's how I see it. I just put the larger items there, and I probably don't need these sewing kits anymore, at least. Mechanical parts I'll need. Oh, oops. I think the cops can actually kick down the door if that alarm's on for too long. Oh good, and he's got the metal pipe, so I'm going to use that to make the thing I want. T stacks to 3. I don't want to get drugged up, so I'm not going to take that, actually. Let me just finish looting the house at this point, actually.
What's that?
Yeah, that was me trying to push with the thing out, the frying pan out. It just, it takes too long to do it, so I just hide the frying pan and just pretend that's, I don't know, just the barehanded fighting is probably best. If you're up against like two people are chasing you and you insist on actually killing them instead of just trying to run away, then it's probably more worth it to actually start using the weapon if you have them. Tough linen again, I don't need multiple tough suits though. Okay, yeah, so let's open both doors now. Yeah, I raided all this, right? No, I don't need that. That's empty. And yeah, I don't need this house anymore. And yeah, I'm still right here, so I'm gonna dump half this stuff down there just so I have inventory space. And I'll eat some of the food and drink some of the water I have because I'm starting to get, my character's starting to get thirsty. Actually, I'm gonna have a sip of water myself as well. Hopefully you heard that slurp to prove that that was actual water I was drinking. Okay, good. I was just checking that my character didn't get high from the tea. I know it sounds silly when I say it out loud, but that's how the game works. I'm just clearing up some space now to make the weapon that I like. Hammer pipe. Once again, sounds silly, but it's how the game works. And it also clear up a little bit of space. Sewing kit, needles. I can make a first aid kit that's gonna fully heal me, and if I have any wounds, it'll close those, like if I'm bleeding. So that does come in handy. The syringe is like if my character's tripping, or if he's high, whatever it's called, it'll drain the purple bar. That's pretty much all it does. It's, if you watch what you're doing, you don't really need it. Syringes go there. Broken multi-tool I'll keep with me because there's multiple of these benches in other places. It's not like that's the only one. If it was the only one, I would just leave it here. Pill bottle. Most likely not going to need. Mechanical parts I might need. This I might need. Bandages can come in handy. The pills I'll hold on to. Do I have... Yeah, I like alcohol and jerky together. They're a funny combination because one takes a little hunger and gives you a lot of thirst. The other does the opposite. Takes a little thirst, gives you a lot of hunger. Together, they kind of cancel each other out. And they're a good healing pair. I personally think the organized inventory is important. Just so you actually have room for other stuff when you want to use other stuff. Items that stack, I would recommend not keeping down here, for example, like this steak, because if I have one steak down here and another one in my inventory, it doesn't stack them. If I wait till it reaches the max, like example, think steak goes to 3. Yeah, stacks and lots of 3 says it right underneath the stats, and I just pointed at my screen like you could see my hand. Alright, what am I at? Middle of, end of day 2. Middle of day 2, whatever you want to call that. I guess now I want to look for... I guess I should start killing cops. Just gotta get their attention. Yeah. And then I just try to take them to like a little corner back here where there's not gonna be people. running and jumping get their attention pretty easily. And then I just push them and punch them. Same as fighting everyone else, it just takes a little bit longer. Okay, I thought I heard others. He should be done soon, I think. Yeah, but see, that one club would have done so much more damage if I didn't have the thick suit on. I don't really know where she came from, but she's gonna die. And now they're both dead. Hopefully I'll get some decent loot out of this. And no, I don't count the frying pan as decent loot. 15, no, okay, yeah, so now I'm just gonna keep pulling cops back here and preferably one by one.
Lovely day for it.
Yeah, if someone gets suspicious, if you just like wave at them, say lovely day for it, usually they'll like settle down, but right now it didn't seem to work. Okay, good, you can always fit between those. And by you, I mean me, and me, I mean the player. Sometimes they'll call me a kangaroo when I jump in place. I always found that a little humorous. After I kill this guy, I'll do that house over there just because the window's open. Helps if you corner them. Their clubs are not really that great. I don't know why they... That's the weapon they decided to give them, but... Where's the dishwasher? Sewing kit. Potatoes. Okay, victory meat I didn't even want. I don't really need that either. Really, at this point, I'm just looking for metal bits, and since there's two doors here, the thing to shut off the alarms is gonna be upstairs. Oh, okay, this is how I was talking about. This is actually another house next door, overlapping this house. As of now, they can't really... open doors themselves. Occasionally I've seen the cop guys kind of kick down a door. And I know sometimes if I push them onto the bed, they kind of like turn around sometimes. And it actually lets me do the takedown thing, which makes it a little bit easier. Pocket expansion kit, that's probably one of the best ones in the game. Each row is 10, starts you at 440, and now I have 50. It's convenient. Getting 25%. Well, this one was 25%, the next one's also 10, so it becomes 20%. From having an inventory that was full, or one or two things away from being full, to that is definitely a good catch. I've heard that referred to as a loot roll. I guess that makes sense, roll being like a seated randomizer. Something like that. I'm pretty sure most of the stuff is set up before I'm actually dropped into it. However, there's really no way to prove that unless I got my hands on the actual code, which I barely know Unreal Engine 4, so I wouldn't fully know what I'm looking at anyway. He had a lead pipe, so I might be able to, I don't need dark linen. I need the fancy linen, luxurious, whatever it's called. The main point of black powder is to make craft an item I never use. It kind of looks like a Molotov cocktail. I never used it, so I don't know if that's how it works. Oh, okay, my character is getting really thirsty. Oh, okay, I think I caught the attention of two guards instead of just one, so... Alright, let's see, let's do that. And purified water, what's it? It might give me the bottle back, there's no reason I took something out of my inventory. Yeah, it did give me the bottle back. Oh, shit. Alright, my game was a little glitchy. That was just the two of them knocking me down, I think, yeah. I have no interest in taking on two of them. You know what, fuck it, I'll take on both of them. Oh, I just drank water. How's my guy thirsty already? Okay, I'm using... Actually, not yet. Oh, what the fuck? Okay, I'm not gonna use my med kit, but I'll use... a cough medicine. Oh, now my guy's all drugged out. Yeah, my guy's drugged out, so I'm bleeding also. He's dead. He's dead. Okay. So that's three of them. Security key card. Okay, so I pretty much have just about all the items I'll need. Which is good. What beverages do I have? Alcohol? And... Alright, that's okay, I guess. I'm going to go pick up my other suit and fill up these bottles. I just need one more metal bit. Actually, I'll get one more metal bit first. I could just probably find those in trash cans. Eventually, I'll use a med kit just to... What the hell? That's weird. Metal bit, okay. Yeah, so I actually have all the items necessary to beat the game. And I didn't even get to show you the butcher. If I pass the butcher's house at one point, I'll just do it. Well, that's the thing for the lockpick, I already did that. I just heard the sound again. Do I just have a regular bandage? Yes, I do. That's just to stop the bleeding. Hmm. Actually, I need those two. Okay, so craft. Craft. Okay. I only have one lead pipe. I thought I had another one. Huh. Simple suit. Yeah, see how it's a negative conformity? I'll take the other one just so I can blend in a little bit better. And I'll just put that down there. Yeah, so I'm gonna go back to the beginning of the game and wait. Oh, I was gonna say. I should have two bottles to fill up, right? Yeah. Oh, three. Nice. Okay, you know what? In that case, I think I'm just gonna make the black suit, just because it's better than the simple suit. Not really, but I can tell myself it's better. Oh, I have to equip that, okay. I mean, it's better than the simple suit. Not much, but I can get away with running in this. Thick suit, simple suit. Okay, so I'm going back to the very beginning of the game. To fill up some water. And then I'm going to go and... Do I have enough food? I shouldn't need much, but to get past the security thing, I have to get myself drugged up a little bit. And... I have some food, just because it takes away some hunger, but if I try to do it quick enough... And I don't do it at night like I tried doing last time, just because there's more security guards at night. Okay, so crouching is an instant flag. I don't good, I have a water right on the others. Yeah, I don't even have to go far. I would have really liked to have the fancy thing just to be able to run. It'll really help in the last part, having that fancy suit, just be able to run as I need to, but I mean, this fancy suit doesn't really do shit. I'll show you in the top corner what it's meant to do. I mean, the fancy suit's good. The dark suit that I have doesn't really do anything. Yeah, so when I crouch, so it's push. Yeah, see how the eye is like pretty much shut? I think it just means like at night time I can't be seen too good. And now my character's hungry. How little can I get away with eating? You know what? The tea and coffee does joy, and I want to get my guy as... Oh, no, they don't. Those are both tea. Okay, so I really don't have any food. Alright, I gotta go into another house or two. If I get really lucky, I'll find another pipe to make another pipe hammer. If I get even luckier than that, I'll get the fancy fabric to make the, fancy suit. The way that the game does it, that if you're wearing the simple suit, you're just like everyone else, so you should blend in. If you walk normal, you're like everyone else, they don't care. Running, jumping, crawling, crouching, that stuff is abnormal, so that's why they freak out and you get attacked. They're just scared. And if I fell off just then, I would have been so upset. Good clearance. definitely gonna go crazy in the houses. Do I have the... yeah, I do. Electro lock, shocker, and advanced. Picture's the same. Maybe they'll fix that. Or change that. It's not really fixing, it's something broken. Good in this house. Carrots, okay. Stew. I thought I had stew. Oh. Yeah, try to take things like alcohol and health kits or the water. Things that don't stack are ideal to go down there. That was the first time I've seen them out of the room. They must have been coming back upstairs from downstairs. Yeah, so now if it's not something I'm going to be, like, immediately using, I can just get rid of it. Like, syringes, not gonna use it. Sewing kits I'll keep. Pill bottles I'll get rid of. Actually, what's in a med kit? Bandage, syringe, pill bottle. I have bandages, syringes, and pill. How many can I make? Empty pill bottle. Syringe, bandages, and how do I make... yeah, I'll fucking keep it. I'll make more bandages, I guess. That way I can craft some of those. No cloth. Huh. Cloth, I actually want that. Okay, yeah, so now I can make, like, I'm almost able to make two. Pocket expansion kit, nice. Okay. Rearranging some stuff, but at this point I pretty much just need food and water, maybe health supplies. Oh, two of them. Alright. I mean, part of me is just hoping that I kind of find the, I forgot what it's called. Fine linen. Charcoal and cloth. Hmm. That house was actually glitched. Sometimes that happens with the door. I need to be heading north, actually. I still don't have confidence in the amount of food items I have. What actually does anything to hunger? Is that it? Not gonna lie, it's the first time I ever did that. I don't need the rotten apple, I can get rid of that. Two doors means the thing's probably upstairs. Wait, what? Oh, okay. That was a waste. Oh, my character's stuck. I guess I'm not supposed to have been able to have done that. Alright, so every time I've gotten stuck, I've done save in main menu, gone back in, and it usually spawns me a little next to where I was. And I hope this didn't end. I'm just like, I'm doing really good right now. So now I'm relatively free. Yeah, they were waiting by that door because they weren't expecting me to come from that door, so... Joy pill. That's peculiar. Okay. Let's see. I don't need any power cells. I'm not gonna need the canteen because I don't use that. Oh no. Okay. This is where the thick suit comes in handy. And hopefully I can get his iron pipe. Lead pipe. And can I do? Why can't I do purified water? No room in inventory.
Break
have them. No, they don't. So I'm going to make purified water. And I'm just going to use a health kit now. Mainly to stop the bleeding. And to open both doors because I'm done in here. This house has been a huge mistake. Okay, my character is extremely hungry, so I'm gonna use a beef jerky. And an alcohol. Oh, okay, and it gave me the bottle back. Oh, okay, and as you can see the giant buildings over here. This is the final city. Okay, I've just been referring to this as the police precinct. I don't really know what else to call it. So I'm gonna make sure I have my advanced electroshocker and my multi-tool. So let's take a joy pill. Where are my joy pills? Yeah, so see how the bar is just a little more than halfway? It's the exact amount you want for here. You don't get their other means. Because when you go through this, there's going to be fog. There's pumped joy straight into this building. So if you stay in here too long, you will overdose. But as you can see, the thing on top is green. They don't expect me of anything. Until I started running just then, but back to green. I'm going to come down from this joy buzz soon. That's when I gotta pretty much use up the rest of my food and water. And in this town, there's only two things of mention. One is the middle here, which is the actual main goal. And I have to draw these guys' attention little by little. Just slightly draw them away, one by one. Do I have apples or anything? What else do I have? Yeah, so I found it works best to just walk up till one of them recognizes you. Like, he'll drop his arms, he'll do something. Bring him to a area. No, see, I went too far away. He said, fuck that. Oh, no, we did not. Well, I got his attention at least. So I'm going to take them between these two buildings here and just beat the shit out of them. This is the only time I really actually use weapons in this game. Is the kind of like this ending part here. If my durability really drops that low on this weapon... Yeah, they'll call you a kangaroo if you jump. It's kind of funny. Shit. I have to get further away. That guy is gonna notice. And I search them, they sometimes have apples and stuff. And yeah, so I pretty much have to pick off those four guards of this thing. I guess separating these two would probably be my biggest.
What do you want about? Stop making me nervous.
If I take them far enough away. Okay, yeah, so it looks like I won't be able to split them up, so I'm just gonna take them both on. Oh wow, they're really fucking my guy up. Okay, hold on. Health's not a problem. Food's a problem. Oh, what the fuck? Gotta be right behind me. Hopefully this was one of the four that was at the middle, so I only have to deal with two. Preferably one of those two middle guys, because they're hard to split up. I don't know where he went, but... And that's it. That's how you win this game. Well, the alpha, at least. I would say if you just Google it, you should be able to find their, Kickstarter. It's only $60 for this alpha. You get all the updates for the alpha, I believe, as well as you definitely get the beta and final release when it comes out. But other than that, that's how you play this game. There's everything to it. And I hope you enjoyed this, and maybe other videos soon to come from me. Take care. Bye.